An air embolism occurs when one or more air bubbles enter a vein or artery and block it. This can happen in various contexts, such as during surgical procedures with intravenous lines, or as a result of trauma or certain medical interventions. The embolism can travel to the brain, heart, or lungs, causing serious and potentially life-threatening complications, which is what we're going to discuss in this quick video. So if you're ready, let's get into it. You may be wondering, are air embolisms fatal? The answer is yes. Air embolisms can indeed be fatal, depending on the size of the air bubble and where it lodges. If a large amount of air is introduced into the vascular system, it can impede blood flow in a critical area, such as the brain, heart, or lungs. This can lead to organ damage or failure, and if not treated promptly, death. The time until an air embolism becomes fatal can vary widely and depends on several factors, including the amount of air, where, of course, larger volumes are more dangerous. The location of the blockage, because an embolism in the brain, heart, or central circulatory system is more immediately life-threatening than in smaller, peripheral vessels. And the patient's age and overall health can impact how quickly complications develop. Fatal outcomes can occur within minutes if the embolism is significant and blocks major blood vessels. In some cases, smaller air bubbles might be absorbed into the bloodstream without causing serious harm, but this should never be assumed. Prevention of air embolism, especially in medical settings, is critical and includes careful IV and arterial line management to ensure that lines are free of air and correctly primed, utilizing proper techniques and equipment during surgeries to minimize the risk of air entering the vascular system. Decompression sickness prevention is important for scuba divers, and following safe ascent practices is essential to prevent the formation of gas bubbles in the blood. And awareness in high-risk medical procedures like central venous catheter placement or neurosurgery carry higher risks, so extra precautions must be taken. Immediate treatment for an air embolism may involve proper positioning, oxygen therapy, supportive care, and hyperbaric oxygen therapy in some cases. And as previously mentioned, prompt medical attention is crucial in the event of a suspected air embolism. The precise nature of treatment will depend on the individual case and should be administered by qualified healthcare professionals. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.